A rare Tuesday night 8-game slate, and it worked out well for us. Hopefully, we can keep it going tonight. Alongside Drew Dinkmeyer of DailyRotor.com, I'm Greg Sussman. Drew, what's going on?
8 games last night, 10 games tonight, a lot of games in the association this week, so you got to be on the prowl for news and injury information as teams are on the front end or back end of back-to-backs, but it's a full slate and it's an exciting slate of games tonight.
Absolutely, and last night, Danny Green, one of those late scratches for no reason, a guy we absolutely loved. We got a lot of heat on Twitter for it, but hey, it's not our fault they decided to rest him out of nowhere. Hopefully it doesn't happen tonight. At point guard is where we will start, as always, and Brooklyn seems like a good place to do so.
Yeah, Danny Green was scratched in that matchup with the Hawks last night. Hawks playing on the second night of a back-to-back tonight. And one of the reasons we liked Danny Green last night was because, you know, the Hawks lead the league in steals allowed, and they play at a fast pace. They allow a lot of turnovers. Steals and blocks are ways to get yourself some upside with the official NBA scoring. And so tonight we're going back to that matchup against the Hawks, this time with Spencer Dinwiddie, whose price tag is down a little bit. The minutes have been a little bit volatile of late. But he still got that huge role opportunity with the absence of Caris LeVert and Allen Crabb. They will get Joe Harris and Damari Carroll back tonight, which deepens out their wing rotation. But we still think Spencer Dinwiddie's a little bit underpriced for a matchup with Atlanta, which ranks bottom two in the league in defensive efficiency against opposing point guards. So expect Dinwiddie to come off the bench, but expect him to play well tonight and pay off that low 6,000s price tag.
Obviously, the matchup is right. Like you mentioned here, Drew, depending on the guys coming back, we'll see. And hopefully, Dinwiddie's production will not be affected all that much. At the shooting guard position, Utah's Donovan Mitchell. It's been a relatively rough sophomore season, I think, for fantasy owners, at least in season-long leagues. He's asked to do a lot in Utah, and it hasn't always worked out. Now, Ricky Rubio's out for the next couple of weeks, which means the usage for Donovan Mitchell should go up.
Absolutely. Without Ricky Rubio and Dante Exum, you've got the two primary ball handlers there for Utah, both out of the lineup for an extended period of time here. Certainly, Raul Neto will step into that starting lineup, but the ball's going to be in Donovan Mitchell's hands a lot more. And in that last game that Ricky Rubio went down, Donovan Mitchell played 20 minutes in the second half. So we've got him with a high 30s minutes projection. We think over the course of the next 2 weeks, with both Rubio and Exum out, you will see Donovan Mitchell's price on the rise. We want to be early buyers of that price tag. We think the matchup with Orlando is a fair one. Orlando struggled on this road trip out west, got hammered last game by Sacramento. We think this is a good bounce back spot for Utah, who's played a very difficult schedule to this point in the season and has kind of held them back in the Western Conference standings. This is the start of a little bit of a softer stretch for them. I think this is a good opportunity for Donovan Mitchell to start to turn his sophomore season around.
Yeah, this is probably the time he's going to need to do it. Push Utah up those playoff standings in the Western Conference, and we'll see if Donovan Mitchell can get it going tonight. At the small forward position, the Los Angeles Lakers a bit rudderless right now without LeBron James, without Kyle Kuzma, and without Rajon Rondo. And the head coach, Luke Walton, said, "We need players like Lonzo Ball and Brandon Ingram to step up." Is this the night that happens?
I think so. And certainly, you know, at both shooting guard and small forward, the featured game tonight is going to be this, you know, battle between Giannis Antetokounmpo and James Harden. And those guys are great plays. You don't need us to tell you that. But if you're looking for a little bit of salary relief at the position and kind of an upper mid-tier play, we've got Brandon Ingram as the next highest projected small forward behind Giannis Antetokounmpo tonight. The matchup at home against a Detroit team that's playing on the front end of a back-to-back is a particularly favorable one for the Lakers. You know, they've played a lot of Western Conference foes in the absence of LeBron James, and those are all difficult matchups because the Western Conference is so deep this year. Detroit has played well, but they're not quite as strong as some of those Western Conference playoff contenders. The Lakers get them at home here on the front end of a back-to-back. Expected to be a competitive game with a lot of lines on this slate with, you know, double-digit type spreads. So we like Brandon Ingram at 6,900. We've appreciated the improved assist rate in the absence of LeBron James. We thought that would go to Lonzo Ball early on, but really Brandon Ingram's taken over a lot of the ball handling responsibilities, and at 6,900, we still view him as a great value.
And that makes sense as well. Lonzo Ball, Brandon Ingram, both expected to get heavy minutes and heavy usage tonight for the Lakers. At the power forward position, Drew, a guy that I locked into my lineup last night was Domantas Sabonis, no Miles Turner, which means Sabonis starts and plays heavy minutes. Kylo Quinn becomes the value play at center for Indiana. Second night of a back-to-back, Miles Turner questionable, which means more Sabonis.
Yeah, it looks like it's going to be another start for Domantas Sabonis. Miles Turner isn't quite ready to come back just yet. And obviously, second night of a back-to-back is a little bit of a concern, as is the matchup with Boston, a team that has always been a good defensive team. But they've struggled a little bit more against the center position since they've been playing the last few weeks without Aaron Baines, who's been such a good defensive stalwart for them. And they haven't been able to really extend Al Horford's minutes up into the 30s like he was into last season. So I think Sabonis is still a little bit underpriced for his starter's role. It gives him an extra expectation of about 5 to 6 minutes, and that's super valuable in fantasy. I think he's one of the stronger upper tier plays. And then with news that Devin Booker is a little bit more doubtful than he is questionable, it sounds like you're going to get another opportunity for Josh Jackson, who is one of the strongest value plays on the entire slate, priced below 5,000 at a thin power forward position. There's not a lot of great plays. They're also on the second night of a back-to-back, but just a huge opportunity set in the absence of Devin Booker for some of these young players on Phoenix like D'Anthony Melton, Josh Jackson, Kelly Oubre to kind of step in and fill those roles at cheap price tags.
A lot of good options on the slate, but as Drew mentioned, back-to-backs kind of makes things a bit interesting. Kelly Oubre and Domantas Sabonis, two of those guys, on the second night here of a back-to-back. One position left to go, and that's at center, where the Brooklyn Nets' Jarrett Allen is one of many options available on tonight's slate. Drew, how can we like him?
I always like Jarrett Allen when you get him priced below 6,000 because he's so good for the scoring, such a great shot blocker and able to really, dominate the boards in kind of softer matchups. And I think that's the case with Atlanta, a team that has struggled to rebound the basketball at times this year. Allen priced at 5,800. There's a ton of center options you can choose. Joel Embiid's in a good spot. Andre Drummond's in a good spot. DeAndre Ayton is still priced really well after we liked him quite a bit yesterday. But Jarrett Allen, not on a back-to-back where so many of the centers are on back-to-backs on this slate. He's priced down, and he's got this matchup with the Hawks where the Brooklyn Nets have an implied total somewhere in the high 117, 118 range. That's really, really high for them. And so we like attacking the Nets. We like Spencer Dinwiddie. We like D'Angelo Russell. And we like Jarrett Allen tonight.
The Nets, a popular play according to DailyRoto.com. But as Drew mentioned at the top, cannot set your lineup without the updates during the lineup lock hour from 6 to 7. So make sure you are locked into DailyRoto.com right then, because you never know what's going to happen. Drew Dinkmeyer, DailyRoto.com. Thanks so much for joining me, man.
Thanks so much, Greg. Best of luck in your games tonight.
Absolutely. Best of luck to you, Drew. And best of luck to all of you watching. We appreciate it. Good luck. And let's win some cash. We'll see you tomorrow.